Okay. Good morning, everyone. We are the Germano Milgate Spring interns. We are here to present the work we've been doing this spring, as well as what we're proposing to get done this summer. So the process began with a community meeting that was attended by three artists who each created an artistic proposal based on their experiences.
Hey, so, hello, my name is Jamila Perkins.
Hello, I'm Doreen McClendon.
Hello, I'm Jeff Parker.
Hello, I'm Beyonce Bailey.
I'm Marquita Courtney.
And I'm Stacey Jackson.
Okay, so the first artist proposal, his name was Jorge Felix. Now what he wanted was 1 12-foot tall SSO Lulu tree. And I got one right here. And he wanted either on a building wall located on the office, which is right here, or he wanted on free land. He wanted the tree already painted green, and he wanted the last name of the Germano resident inscribed on the tree branches. So he wanted on the tree. And plus he wanted to add lights to it, but that wouldn't be able to work. He also wanted like a second proposal, like a second project, which involves a summer program up to 12 to 15 high school students. We wanted to utilize the ancestry.com to do family research. Now the reason why we did not like this idea is because it was expensive. We had some concerns about the size of the names on the branches, whether we can see it from a distance or up close. The aluminum tree was not interactive, so that means that we wouldn't be able to be hands-on as a team. It would be already made by our company. And the artist and his idea didn't seem very flexible. He wasn't ready to downsize the tree for us. And we also had questions about new members, like who moves in, like would their names be planted on the tree or not. So the reason why we did like this idea is because the tree would be outstanding. It would be very interesting seeing the aluminum ancestry tree just glowed up right there. And the identity aspect, we found it very interesting. And it'll be very interesting to know about our family history. And that was it for Jorge's proposal.
The next proposal came from Josue. His proposal was to do comic book strips over the complex. He wanted to do 10 to 12 comic book strips based on Germano Man and Germano Woman. These are characters that already exist here at Germano. His idea also contained us doing a selfie stand within the park. We chose to do his idea and we downsized it some. Instead of doing Germano Man and Germano Woman, these are hieroglyphics. It's coded messages through pictures. We wanted to take that part of his idea and use it, but instead scratch the part about Germano Man and Germano Woman and use emojis so that we can kind of connect to the youth that are currently living here. Another part of his project was take the children to Millennium Park, and he also wanted to do art classes. We've done art classes in our past summer, so we figured that that was a good idea, but it was a few things about poor Josue's idea that we did not like. Some parts of it was a little bit too time consuming and we couldn't come up with an effective strategy to get it done, so we kind of mixed in our own thing. The last proposal that we had was Kiara's. This was part of Kiara's idea, which was the fences. The reason why we did not like this part was because the material for the project was too easily to be tampered with. So we decided to scratch that part. Another idea that Kiara had was a Skillshare. We thought that it was a great idea because it was a good way to get the people in the community to engage and interact with each other, but we just didn't have enough time within our 8 weeks to plan it, and plus, some of the things that she wanted to have people do, like hair, nails, we had to make sure that those people were licensed. So it just wasn't planned, but it can be something to do in the future. The last part that Kiara had was the park.
Okay. As she said, we
have planned to build a garden. That was Jose and Kiara's plan, because people have mentioned it for the community to look better. This would be made by tires and painted at events more like play strips. We picked three plants, which is marigolds, mint, and sunflower.
Hello, I'll be talking to you about the playground today. So some concerns we have with that, it may become time consuming, there may not be enough space, it can become a safety hazard as far as the chemicals from the tires being toxic. And the reasons why we like the idea are that everybody wants a playground. They've been mentioning it for years. It's cheap, it'll make the community look better. And also the playground will be made out of car tire material, and it'll show that the community can set up and jump for themselves without waiting for an outsider to come in and help. And we also try to get a grant through Kaboom, but it didn't end up working out.
Alrighty, well, you guys heard the three proposals today. So we all sat down, we listened to them, we determined which ones would be the best fit for the budget and for the time. We came up with the locations for the park, which became two parks, older kids park and a younger children's park. Which you see in green outline is the first park, and the other park is shadowed by all the trees. And we planned out how much equipment would be used in each park. We had to go to each section to measure out the spacing for the equipment. And then we figured out where the murals were gonna go from Josue's project. The different X's that you see are where they were going to be placed. Two on 87th, two on 88th, two on 89th, and one in the park, which is the selfie stand.
Okay, and what we chose, although we had to change the projects a bit because of like time and money, we eventually chose two artists, Kiara and Josue, and we chose them because both of them wanted to join together. Like, they weren't having problems with coming together and putting in a project, so, like, because we liked both of them. We chose Kiara's Titan Playground, which would have, like, part of Josue's emoji idea around. And we also chose to do different emoji murals around the complex, which was also Josue's idea. Then they both wanted to add gardens. By downsizing Josue's idea from 8 to 10 double-sided boards to 7 single-sided to save time and resources. In the beginning, it was based on superheroes and everyday heroes that kids know in their lives. But then the objective of the project was swapped for a more modern take on positivity by using emojis to express positive affirmations and phrases, which is like showing on the board on what emoji. And the idea includes a selfie stand to encourage people to interact with art via Instagram and other social media platforms. In order to accommodate accomplishing these ideas, only the playground of recycled tires were incorporated from Kiara's idea.
Any questions?
I have a question. We started by giving our names, but not everybody gave their name. So is it all right if we kind of do a little replay on that and everybody
yes.
give their name?
My name is Jamila Perkins.
My name is Dora McClendon.
My name is Shelby Webb Parker.
My name is Beyonce Baylor.
I'm Arkita Courtney.
And I'm Stacey Jackson.
Okay. Thank you.
Any more questions?
Yes. Were you talking to other people in the community, getting their feedback, or did you mostly talk amongst yourselves?
We went over the information that we've taken in the past that about interviews when we ask people what do they want to see to beautify the community.
Okay, so you took a lot of the past conversations you had.
Yes.
One thing about Germano Millgate that we've noticed over the years, it's not just promises that fade away, but things actually get done. Mm-hmm. So, what do you think? How long do you think it would take before you'd be able to have sort of a grand opening with your new ideas? Wow.
It's during the summertime, so it starts in the summer, when July 10th. July 10th, and it ends on August 24th?
Yes.
August 24th, so we have 6 weeks to get it done.
It's fantastic.
That's good. Are you guys doing all of the work, or are there other people?
Other people. I mean, so we have the summer applications.
Okay. Good math, I don't know.
So, of course, Sean is probably going to pick one or two of us, but around all of us will be new, brand new people to bring in, you know, new opinions, new outlooks for this new program.
Right.
It's the park. I'm excited, though. I'm excited for the city.
And your names will go on this at some point, somewhere?
I'm
applying. Sean, yes.
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 It's good stuff. I just think the park in particular, I think, means a lot to the community and to this group here because as some of these young people who have done this program a few times in the past know that people at Germano have been talking about the playground park since for as long as I've been coming here at least and before that. So I think this is a really powerful way to do it because rather, even in a lot of ways preferable to getting the grant from Kaboom because it shows that we don't necessarily need to rely on outside help. You know, the community can really step up and do something with the resources they have at hand.
And these are your resources, which is wonderful.
Exactly. I mean, there's these fabulous young people here who are very dedicated and very passionate about improving their community. It's been a great pleasure to work with all of them.
So who's going to get to play on the playground first?
I've been talking about this playground.
So the big kids over the little kids, basically.
They're in two separate sections.
Okay. So the big kids aren't going to take over the little kids.
No. No. So the little kids park by the office, we're going to redo that and make the little kids section.
Okay. I'm just eyeing it because I'm
going to
look
out. Yeah, even the equipment that we're placing at each park will be specifically towards the smaller or the older kids. So mm-hmm. there wouldn't really be any way for the older kids to go take over the smaller kids' park because they wouldn't be able to interact with the same equipment because it's going to be made for smaller bodies.
Mm-hmm. We first became involved with your group, I think, seriously involved when you were doing the public art publication that you were putting together as a group. And some of you may have been involved in that, I can't recall now. It's been a couple of years since we got together, but that's one of the finest documents that has come out of the community. That baby, right there, yeah.
Do you think people from outside of Germano would ever be allowed to play in the playground?
Well, that was the purpose of the Instagram page. We were going to take pictures of all of Architecture and Germano period, just positive things that go on so that other people can view it from a distance. And I mean, I don't see any reason why not as a park.
Yeah, right. Maybe that way people can get to know each other.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
And plus, we all are community. Still shouldn't really matter. Mm-hmm. To bring all the positiveness.
Okay. Good job, guys.
Thank you.
As far as publication is concerned, we have a website, well, a couple of websites, one that's more to do with tours, including the public arts and green summits, green sites and things like that. But also, this event that we're doing today will go up on our YouTube site. We have close to 350 videos now over a 10-year period that are basically about the community.
We, you know, some of them draw hundreds of viewers, most of them draw maybe 1,000 or 20, we never know. But it's out there, it's a record. What you had to say here today is there in that one space. Sometimes other people will link to it. Germano Milgate is a search term that they can find on the internet with that sort of analysis. So you are getting your word out now in the form that, as best we can tell it when we put this together. And other ways that you may put it out, like on Facebook or things like that, which we don't do. There are horror stories on Facebook, so we don't use that. But we have to generate the word, because we got started with doing this because years ago when we were involved, all we'd ever hear was body counts coming out of Southeast Chicago. You know, if somebody fell down a stair, there was a mass assault, you know, in the south side, and it was right here in South Chicago, and people were, bodies were flying all over the place. And it doesn't mean that there weren't people getting killed. But all the media downtown we were looking at was body counts. And we said, no, there's other stuff going on. What you're doing is not body counts. And so that piece decided to put that up.
So what is the, you said you guys fix it up, right? You don't have no, like, no type of Instagram either?
I don't hear well with the
like Instagram to, so we can actually watch it ourselves?
Oh yeah, probably before Monday I'll have it up on YouTube.
Okay, because I would like to see.